भद्रं कर्णे शृणुयाम देवा भद्रं पश्येमाक्षतिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुन्धस्तनोभिः यशेम देवहितैर्यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिक्तनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्ददातु ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ
Tradition and being seated during the vacation. I now call upon Srimati Rani Vijayaraghavan to honor Srimati Sudha Raghunathan with a show and a momentum. of the Global GMB Birth Centenary Celebration Committee, it is my honor to extend a warm welcome to this august gathering, who have come together today to celebrate the life and music of the legendary one and only GMB, who was born this day 100 years ago. Namaskar, I am Sujata Ramachandran, and I consider it a privilege to be called upon to do the honors for this five-day function in memory of the great maestro, the one and only GMB. Added to that is the fact that these 5 days would see a host of eminent personalities and performers gracing the event. I would now request our managing committee member, Sri M. Murali, the managing director of the GMB, to deliver the welcome address.
Dr. Karan Singh, our esteemed guest of honor, Professor T. N. Krishnan, the other eminent persons on the stage, and of the members of the organizing committee, distinguished invitees, Vidwans, Vidushis, Rasikas, it is my singular honor and pleasure to be able to say these words of welcome on this very special occasion where so many of us are gathered here today to pay tribute, to celebrate the genius, the qualities, the impact, the profound human qualities of a very, very great Carnatic musician who was not only a legend in his own lifetime, but his impact goes beyond the short span of 55 years he lived, as this huge audience today on his very birth centenary day, it stands testimony to his impact long after he is no more. And he is one musician who has created a unique bani or a style which is not necessarily followed by only his disciples or his disciples' disciples, of which we have Trichay Ramachandran, the direct disciple, and Sudhara Gunadhan, who is his disciple's disciple, and scores of others. But what's really happened is the revolution he spawned, the style, the bani he pioneered, has in its fold many, many musicians who belong to different schools, who may not have had direct tutelage from him or from those who learned from him. I think that is the greatness of this legendary musician whose music is
true. Our managing committee member and president and secretary of the Nagarjuna Sabha, to honor Sri T. N. Krishnan.
There you go.
unfortunately, and of all dignitaries on the stage and the auditorium, ladies and gentlemen. The GMB Board Centenary Committee was conferred by a person with an abundance of enthusiasm and age of only 83 years. I refer to Mr. P. Ramabhadram. He brought the rest of us together and formed a committee. Things then took a momentum all the room. All of us were unanimous in one thing, that the evening must be grand, befitting the grandeur of the legendary genius Sri Jinbi. Events that took place thereafter led us inexorably into a state where everything fell in place and the event evolved into something unusual and extraordinary, as you see today. Dr. Cummings readily gave his assent, while His Highness Sri Martin Verma altered other engagements to be here with us today. So is the case with Mr. Lalit Mohan Singh and Mr. Rajiv Menon. The Gaekwad of Baroda, who is an accomplished Hindustani vocal musician, said he would be delighted to be the guest of honor on the 10th of January 2010. The Maharani of Udaipur, a great patron of the arts, not only agreed to participate on 9, but also said that he would again come on the morning of 10th January to inaugurate the procession of singing of GMB's compositions by 14 young Vidwans and Vidushis. The Princess of Mysore, who is herself a Veena player, said it would be an honor for her to recount Sri GMB's association with the Mysore court. As for the senior Vidwans, Dilip Professor T. N. Krishnan, Dr. Bala Mandi Krishnan, Sri Lalgiri Jayaraman, Dr. Ramani, Sri Umayalpuram Shivaraman, their invaluable advice kept coming continually, reflecting their regard for the maestro. Our star performers like T.N. Seshagopan, Srimati Aruna Sairam and Srimati Sugar Raghunathan took extraordinary effort to be present and to perform on different days without once raising a whisper about remuneration. Similar was our experience with the other South Indian performing artists. As for Begum Parveen Sultana, who sings on 8th of January, I have a most delightful experience to share with you all. When I spoke to her on telephone, she completely floored me by her response. She said, "Are you asking me whether I would sing? Of course I would sing. I would not give up the privilege for anything in my life." GMB is a musician my husband and I have come to venerate over the years, having heard his recordings at the residence of both Srimati M. Vasanthamari and Sri Y.G. Doraiswamy. She said GMB was held in the highest esteem by all North Indian Vidwans, like Pandit Ravi Shankar, Bhim Singh Joshi, besides the late Ustad Bade Gulam Ali Khan. She repeatedly described GMB as a musical genius who must be worshipped like a saint. Not stopping with that, I agreed to speak about GMB before her concert. As for her remuneration, along with two accompanying artists, she slashed it dramatically to just about cover her expenses. Everybody in the committee was moved by her response. The response of Pandit Hariprasad Chaurasia, who performed on the 9th, was equally effusive. The sponsors in the media, without any sense of competition, pitched in to cover the numerous events. One of the co-sponsors, Sheraton Chola, placed a curious condition. They said they were proud to be associated with the project, but they should not be dumped after this year. They sought an assurance that year after year, they would let them be associated with us for the GMB festival, which they said was akin to the Tansen Music Festival up north. The committee was truly overwhelmed and gladly gave the assurance that in the event of any annual event, it would of course associate with them. Mr. V.V. Ramani, the artist, along with two youngsters, Master Aditya and Manshumu, came up with the idea of setting up a special art show on Sri GMB at the Sheraton Chola Gallery from the 6th to the 10th of January 2010. The Master of Ceremonies, Sujata Ramchandran, an accomplished Mohiniyattam artist, has cancelled all her other appointments to conduct the proceedings on all the 5 days. there is one person whose stunning and generous response to this function made him come out with an offer to back the entire event in every conceivable manner, and that is Mr. Ravi Shankar Mangipudi, CEO of General Mills Mineral Resources Private Limited. He said he was moved by the nobility of the event, and in particular by the participation of several young musicians who will be performing on 10th morning. This is only a tip of the iceberg as to what really went on, and it is not my intention to take your time anymore. I'm certain that you would all agree with me when I say that all these can only be attributed to one person, and that is Sri G.M.B. himself, whose enduring magic has brought about this kind of a heartwarming response. Thank you.
Thank you, Sri Vijayabhi. I'm sure GMB is watching the proceedings from the reviews. I now request Professor T. N. Krishna to address the division.
Association with him, accompanying for his concert
as Master Krishna. I never thought, or my father and I never thought, that the day will come when I will play for this concert. I look back when I don't remember it really. I'm choked by words now. And also this I want to tell you about the great giants in Sumandis who are playing with him. The wonderful names Kumbhakonam Rajamani can be like. Mysurti Chaudhaya, Dwaram Venkateswami Naidu, with Palghat Maniyar and Palan Subramani Pillai. These were the accompanies for Jain Balasubramanian in those days. And whenever you walk in Madras streets, you will see the walkers, the great Mysore Jain Balasubramanian, Kumbhakonam Rajamanikam Pillai, or Mysurti Chaudhaya, Palghat Maniyar, or Palan Subramanian Pillai. So these were the days. So when they were all in their prime period, I as a boy entered into the field, and I was welcomed, appreciated and welcomed by these great giants. And today, if I am here, it is because of their blessings and all the music-loving public of the old Madras. Jeevi was a star musician, performer, teacher, composer. He was an institution by himself. His style was a very modern and attractive within the boundaries of classicism. God had given him the golden voice. I repeat, the golden voice. Not only golden, but super fast. You cannot follow him. This is my experience I am sharing with you. To play a sangati which he has sung immediately, to follow me, it is no joke. And not only that, his rendition would be very perfect and precise, and no note will be distorted. So any violinist has to be very careful, and unless you have some kind of intuition and blessings, you cannot cope with the great GMB. But somehow I have survived. So, he has this golden voice, supernatural voice, with a long range to cover all the octaves, which is very rare to hear the ladies. Unfortunately, I have to say that, because that voice, there are good voices, no doubt, but that is something unique. You cannot put it in words.
discipline and hard work and sadhana gave him the highest position in Carnatic music, which he retained till his last. And imagine, he left us 45 years ago. And to have a celebration like this after he left us 45 years ago, to remember him and celebrate like this is possible only for GMB. It is only for GMB. Suppose you may celebrate my centenary in another 20 years. But it's very close. I am 82 now, and 20, about 100 is just 15 years. So you will not forget. But after 45 years, you will not remember me like GMB. So that is his greatness. That was his greatness. That is GMB. Besides his scholarship, he was a man of high principles, manners, broad-minded person, performer. And he was very, very cordial, very, very cordial with all fellow artists. Not only that, he will encourage deserving youngsters, not deserving youngsters, only deserving youngsters. And he is very fond of youngsters. And our association, it was like from childhood I've been with him. So when I was a boy of 7, 8, it was like a father and son. But later it was like a brother and elder brother and younger brother. So he was a very lovable person, very affectionate and very sensitive man. He cannot tolerate nonsense, and he doesn't want to pretend. That is the thing. Everything black and white. And when something upsets him, he cannot hide it. And straight away tell the people or who it is, bluntly he said that you did the wrong thing and I cannot accept. And for some time he will feel very bad. But after some time, you will see a different GMB, as if nothing has happened, and you will be very affectionate, and again, you will be very cordial. So he was a childlike person. And now, the money bottles, he has performed any number of concerts, and he has seen many awards, and he is responsible for elevating this stature of music and musicians and their monetary benefits. In those days, a musician used to get only 250 or 300 rupees at best, maximum. But he was the person who reached the four digits, thousand rupees those days, and that helped all the other musicians to get that. And now, but if you calculate that money and the present day remuneration, it is nothing. It was 1,000 rupees then, now it is musician gets lakh of rupees now. But the value is that is more, that is more, but not the lakh of rupees today. So he has brought stature to music and musicians, and everyone knew that what his contribution to the film world. So I need not say anything more. I respect him, respect GMB, and his popularity. When I see you all here, his popularity perhaps increased now. You can clap very well. Don't hesitate. You are giving the clap to GMB and not for me. So I don't want to. I have so many things to say, but there are many speakers and they want to share joy with you. The only thing is, I thank everybody here for giving me the opportunity to stand before you on this great occasion, and I take it as a blessing from the great GMB, whom I continue to adore. So that is the legend, great legend, G.N. Balasubramanian. Long live GMB's music and contribution. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for sharing with us your rich experiences and encapsulating the greatness that was the timeless legend. Our other guest of honor is His Highness Sri Uttaradam Perumal Maharaja, the Maharaja of Travancore. We are indeed grateful to His Highness for changing his schedule and accepting our invitation at short notice and to be with us this evening. This is also a reflection of his regard for GMB and his association with the Swati Perumal College and the Travancore Samsthanam. I call upon our Managing Committee member, Sri S. Vijayaraghavan Advocate, to honor His Highness. Request him to deliver his address.
Came out with a question which I should have
century. The word is sorry. That is what I have to tell you. I have been compelled to accept and enjoy the impatience of being raised. G.N.B. Gana Nada Bhushan. After hearing so much about him, my little knowledge would be of little use, but I would like to bring to the notice of everybody here a few instances of his contact with the state and the family. G.N.B. was once upon a time known as a Travancore Asthana Vidwan. He has sung Narada Swatimara's Kritis more than half a century in Trivandrum. And I knew from Bruce as well, the musician does not sing to audience, but to divinity. It is a summon to Saraswati Devi. Saraswati Devi in Travancore and all the devis of the world. There is a great Tamil poet called Kamba who wrote the great Kamba Ramayana, and he had a Saraswati Vigraha to which he would do puja before he started using the Ramayana. He being a person of extra sensory religious mind and thought knew that his Ekadokavasam was coming to a close. He went straight to Padmanabhapuram and handed over his vigraham to my ancestor. The same Saraswati vigraham which comes in 9 days to Trivandrum to be worshipped with Nagam and Ganam and Kritis and Sahitya. It is to that audience, to that single audience, that G.N.B. has sung for 25 continuous years. Another thing that comes to mind is that he was a multifaceted personality. He could be a musician, he could be a gentleman at dinner, he could be a filmmaker, he could be a marvelous, unnecessary support to somebody very low in the field of music. All this strays through my mind on this momentous occasion. Mistake, I do not want to make another mistake of talking to you too much. But I'd make one more remark about my being sorry. It is, I know, bad manners to sit and talk to people. You should stand and talk. But permit me to tell you that that is not an Indian custom. I have, unfortunately, a leg problem which prevents me from standing for long durations of time. I am happy to be here this evening and to know that the people of this musical city of Madras have decided they will be a little late to honor the great musician who has been not only great in music, but many facets of human. One incident I will tell you was after he acted in Shakuntala and he came to see my mother, he would sing both parts of Dushyanta and Shakuntala to demonstrate to her what the film was all about. Let us hope is with all of you that this will become an annual feature in the city, and I am sure that the good wishes of all of you will become a certainty. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. May I now make a selfish question. I would like to send to His Highness, who is presiding over this function, a small token of regard. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Highness. It is now time to release the GMB souvenir to mark this auspicious occasion. I request His Highness, Srila Pandavarma, to release the souvenir, and I request Padma Professor T. M. Krishna to receive the first copy. I would request our President, Dr. Karan Singh, to honor Thrishur V. Ramachandran. Dr. Karan Singh needs no introduction to this august gathering. Hailing from royal vintage, he has adorned many a position of importance in the Republic of India, whether as ambassador, cabinet minister, or as he now does the post of the president of ICCR. This committee deems it extremely fortunate and a blessing to have found such a worthy personage to preside over this function this evening. May I request Sri A. Murli to honor Dr. Karan to deliver the presidential address.
Maharaja Sahab, Sri T. N. Krishnan, very distinguished personages seated on the dais, and members of the audience representing a wide spectrum of music lovers, young and old, a very impressive gathering indeed. I was wondering as to what really there was a justification for being here. And then I realized that no function in India is really national unless Kerala and Kashmir are both represented. In fact, one of the definitions of India is Aasetu Himalaya Paryantam.
And the Himalayas, as you know, are essential for the success of any function. Kalidasa in his Kumara Sambhava starts with the magnificent description of the Himalayas. Astuttarasyam Dishidevatatma Himalayo Nam Nagadiraja Purvaha Paroto Yanidhi Vagahya Sthitaha Prithivya Ivamanadanda. He describes the Himalayas as a Devatatma, as a divine presence. And therefore, the only justification of my being here is that I am a Himalaya Putra and I have come here to pay my homage to an extremely outstanding human being. I would like to congratulate the organizers for arranging a 5-day music festival in memory of the great musician, the great savant, about whom you have heard so much just now, and about whom Sri Krishna reminded me that half a century ago I also attended a concert in which GNB and Sri T. N. Krishnan were both performing. When we honor great personalities like GNB, we are not only fulfilling our responsibility to such great genius, we are also encouraging younger people to come up to that standard. Because a nation or a society that does not honor its great artists is really not fulfilling its societal obligations. Because it is these great people in whatever field, as the Gita says, yat yat tacharati shreshtas tat tatai vitaro jana sa yat pramanam kurute lokas tatam vartate. Whatever the leaders, I'm not talking of political leaders, the less said about political leaders the better, but I'm talking about leaders in the field of art, in the field of music, in the field of dance, in the field of architecture, in the field of business, in every field. There's such a tremendous genius in India, and we have produced such outstanding people. In our thousands of years history, we have produced scientists, we have produced historians, we have produced philosophers, we have produced musicians of every sort. And it is our duty and our privilege to recognize them and to honor them. And a centenary indeed is a very important occasion for such an honoring. India is very rich in almost every tradition, but in the field of music and dance particularly, our heritage goes back thousands of years. The Sama Veda was to be sung. The Bhagavad Gita is a song, it's a song of God, it's not just to be listened to, it's supposed to be sung. And music has become an integral part of our national culture. Every state, every linguistic group in India have produced great musicians. But I would particularly like to highlight the tremendously significant role played by Tamil Nadu in the preservation and the propagation of our cultural heritage. At a time when we in the north were going through multiple crises and very often fighting for our very existence, it was you who kept this reservoir of dance and of music. You kept it in your bosom. The whole tradition of dance, the great Bharatanatyam tradition, would have been lost to us had you not nurtured it, and you had sent it back to us in the north now. And today in Delhi, in every house, all the girls want to do is, apart from doing the Bollywood dance, they want to do Bharatanatyam. So I would like to express this debt of gratitude. I myself have a strange resonance, Maharaj Sahib, with, I've told you about this, with South India. I love the food, I love the music,
My favorite ragas, as I have told the singer today, are Hindonam, Mohanam and Hamsadhwani. And I love the Nataraja. Nityavasane Nataraja Rayo Nanada Dhakkam Navapanchavaram Uddhartu Kaman Sanakadi Siddhan Yetat Vimarsham Shivasutra Jalam. And believe it or not, I have built a Nataraja temple in Tamil Nadu, in the village Pudukuppam, on the way from here to Pondicherry. I have built a Nataraja temple. Coming all the way from Kashmir, where we had never heard of the Nataraja. Even now people have not heard of it. I built the first Nataraja temple in Jammu, in my Raghunath temple, which is my family temple. We built the second in Swami Sachitananda's ashram in Virginia in the United States. And I built the third here by the Lord's grace in a pyramid, in a perfect pyramid. I wanted to combine the great artifact of the Egyptians, the pyramid, with the greatest artifact of Hindu iconography, the Nataraja. So that combination for the first time has taken place, and it is taking place here at your doorstep. So I would like to express my debt of gratitude to Tamil Nadu and to the cultural heritage of this state, which has given me personally so much satisfaction and so much joy. About the great savant GMB, I will not say very much because it has already been said by people who have worked with him. Shri T.M. Krishnan's description was very moving, of how he has accompanied him on numerous concerts and how he has travelled around the whole country and perhaps even abroad with him. Music, friends, is a divine gift. Music is one of the great gifts of human evolution, because music always is with us. It always soothes us. It always helps us, whether we are old or young, whether we are at home or abroad, whether we are alone or in company, whether we are happy or unhappy, whatever our situation may be, music is always there to lift our spirits. And in the final analysis, when we move towards the divine, music is a powerful methodology. All the great traditions, religions of the world have used music as a potent means for accessing the divine. Sri Krishna says, Yatra Gayanti Mad Bhakta Tatra Tishthami Narada. Lord Shiva himself is the Lord of the cosmic dance and dances in ecstasy with the Ananda Tandava. The Sufis, the great Sufis of Central Asia, of Persia and of Turkey, when they do their zikr, when they do their dance, they dance to the rhythms of music. The Guru Granth Sahib, the entire book is written with each verse and each song with a special rag and a special thought also. So music is inherent in our spiritual striving.
And I would only say this, that I am happy that with all the problems and difficulties we may be facing in the country, and all the violence and all the negativity that we come across, nonetheless, the tradition of music is flourishing. And I am sure it will continue to flourish, mainly because of our Guru Shishya Parampara. Both the Hindustani music and the Karnataka music tradition, because of the hymn of the Guru Shishya Parampara, have been flourishing. And it cuts across religious barriers. In the Hindustani music, the Muslim gharanas have done more to maintain the continuity and the grandeur of Indian music, of Hindustani music perhaps, even than the Hindu gharanas. So music is not the monopoly of any one religion or any one caste or any one creed. Music belongs to the entire human race. And therefore, when we pay homage to G.M. Balasubramanian, we pay homage not only to a great artist, but we pay homage to music itself. Sri Aurobindo has a lovely line, all music is only the sound of his laughter. All music can be defined as a resonance from within. And therefore let us today pay homage to him, and also let me thank all of you, and let me hope that you will all continue, despite Bollywood music, to nurture the musical tradition that you have, to enrich it even further. That is my prayer. I'll end with the prayer to Mahalakshmi. May she shower her blessings upon all of us. May she give us the courage and the wisdom to meet with fortitude and courage the challenges that lie ahead. May she give us the inner strength and the inner power to fulfill our inner spirit and our spiritual yearnings, and to rise to our highest possibilities. Ya sa padma sarastha vipula katitani padma patraya kakshi dambhira vartana bhisanabharana mita shubhra vastrottariya lakshmi divyai vijendrahi manujana khajitahi snapita hema kumbhai nityam sa padma hasta tava vastu grahe sarva mangalya yukta.
Dr. Singh, for that enlightening speech. This function will not be complete without honoring two special individuals. Padma Shri Srimati Aruna Sai Ram is here today. To offer, may I say, her musical homage to the great master, for which she had to rearrange her pride commitments. To honor her, I request Srimati Lakshmi Menon, the CEO and Director of Event Express, to do the honors. Another special person is Ravi Shankar Mangipudi, the CEO of General Nice Mineral Resources Private Limited, whose extraordinary backing, both financial and otherwise, has been a critical factor in the smooth progress of this 5-day extravaganza planned. Thank you, Ravi. And to do the honors, may I request Shri P. Ramabhadran, convener of this committee. Request Sri R. Krishna Swami to deliver the vote of thanks.
Dignitaries of the Dais and Invitees, it is my pleasure that you propose vote of thanks first to the dignitaries who had participated in today's function and made this function a grand success. You are a great deal of thanks to all the artists from North and South for their wholehearted participation. We wish to thank the General Ice Group, RMK Sheraton Chowana, Vodafone, Suri Lane, Deepan Lampavani, Jaipur Gems Charitable Society, BGN Energy, Sugal and Damani, The Hindu, The Mumbai Express, Dhanamani, Times of India, Kumadam, All the Vigitan, Vijay TV and other press media for their support. We wish to thank the Event Express for managing the event and Narada Gan Sabha for providing the venue. Mr. Ravishankar Manupuri, Chandan Singh, and Rohit Arya for their personal involvement. We also like to thank advocates R. Jayashree and D. Vinayakaran for their support. And lastly, to you all, thank you.